would first like to say that I'm sorry for all the pain that I've caused to others through this whole ordeal. Sometimes the hardest part isn't letting go, but allowing yourself to start over. I could focus on the fact that I robbed myself of many experiences. I'll never get to go to prom. I won't be able to watch my little sisters grow up in a beautiful woman. Or go to a high school football game as a member of the marching band ever again. Or I could focus on my personal growth as a human being. First and foremost, I'm a kid and still will be for quite a while. I'm not the same scared little girl I was over a year ago. And I've done some growing up with attention. I've seen all different kinds of people and now see humanity from a new, compassionate perspective. We can't erase the past or even change it. We can carry the past on our shoulders and we can start over. Each day I wrestle with PTSD and suffer through horrendous flashbacks of the abuse I allowed myself to endure at the hands of my father. But I am learning to let go of the stifling fear, pain, and scars that negated my well-being for so long. This is truly a sad situation in which everyone got hurt and we all still feel the effects in some way. But when we intend for evil, God will work for good. Since being lodged, I've learned of the forgiveness, grace, and mercy of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I am unafraid to trust an unknown future to a known God. I would like to thank and acknowledge the support that I've received from some in the past year. First, I need to thank my legal team, Melissa, Lorian, and Monty, for fighting so hard for me when I didn't know what to believe, and for my future. I want to thank the detention staff and my peers who could not be present for offering kind words of hope and support when I needed it most. The youth 715 ministry leaders deserve so much gratitude for donating their time to share the good news of salvation through Jesus Christ. And I need to thank my mom and my grandma for being the wind beneath my wings. I'll leave you with a quote from one of my favorite authors, Pettichistola. Even when the world throws its force and turns its back, there is still always hope.
Thank you.